That's an afternoon probably best suited for skating in Central Park, but we're across the river and we are in for a cold one at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. Today it's a Week 14 matchup that should be a good one, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the New York Jets. Justin Tucker is the kickoff to Baltimore. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in Week 14. And no return here to start. It's a fair catch, and they will set up shop at the 25. In motion right, that's Wilson. Now a fake on the jet sweep, and they'll instead run up the middle. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Here's a quick throw out to Wilson. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. The Jet first down, 18 big yards that time. That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So that as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football, all right? You're not trying to find the laces and grip it a certain way. That takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how they practice it all the time now, too.
And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
And he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. The Jets at 5-7 now on the year. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it two in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. And I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And they get him behind the line. So that short gain on first down, quickly negated. Now Lewis. He's got his run back down the backfield. Touchdown! A great effort there. His 21st touchdown of the season. And the Jets are on the board first here this afternoon. Well, Charles, kind of the future of this franchise on display right there. You had a rookie throwing it, a rookie catching it, and taking it into the end zone.
Could you imagine if we were in the owner's box right now and we could look at the front office and see the grins on their faces to see the present, making plays, and knowing what the future will bring with these youngsters going out and making big-time moments happen for this team.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 23. They'll start this drive out on the ground. Shifts by him. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
A big hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that run could go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
Again, they'll run. This is McGee. And he's tackled a yard short. short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Absolutely no trouble moving the ball on the ground on the first two plays from scrimmage.
Absolutely. You know what I really like? Same guy carrying the ball in both plays. And what drives me crazy is when a back has a nice run, he taps his helmet to go out of the game. I would want the ball again and again and again because you've established really nice momentum, and now you're seeing the field really well.
Jackson. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. Will McDaniel gets in there to take him down. The defense is always talking about not letting Lamar Jackson get comfortable. A good job there on his opening drive of making him uncomfortable.
And you're talking about doing it so early in the game because all week long, there's been anxiety on the defensive side of the ball. How do we keep this guy hemmed in? How do we tackle him? To get it done that early, that's got to feel great for them.
And he is caught. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. To throw is Jackson. Throw caught by Flowers. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. And the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll run with McGee. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there. Hitting double digits with his 10th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Ravens are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Justin Tucker for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
Partners, a former defensive back, I've got almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. There, they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Throwing is Lewis. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Fights through and now a crease. And now off to the races down the right side. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. 51 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
This has been a good drive so far. It's been a running game for the most part.
Second quarter now from MetLife Stadium. The Jets with the football here as they've got it with a first and 10. Stop before he could even get started. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Focus, boys, focus. this is win.
Behind the chain, second and 13. The slot man in motion right. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. 8 yards on the run, and that cuts this down to a third and about 5.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games.
Touchdown, Jets! A great effort there with their second touchdown in this first half. And the Jets have taken the lead. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 of the 24. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. And it's second down. Play action. Now Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. First target, first catch, and a first down.
A nice job here getting the tight end involved. He's going to line up on the inside, and then off a play action, he's going to test the secondary by running a corner route. His outside receiver takes all the attention deep, and then he'll just find the open space, and he pulls the ball in.
And he'll take it across midfield down into Jet territory. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. Jackson going to keep it running right. That one will go for 9 yards and a first down on the keeper. On the carry, McGee. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Justin Simmons up from his safety spot to make the tackle.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
And they run the option on second down. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. Seven play of this drive coming up. Jermaine Johnson able to record his 5th sack of the season. 4th down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt. Back deep for the Jets, Mecole Hardman. And did he put that on a dime? He did. Wow. Out of bounds at the 1-yard line.
We're certainly not going to see a better punt than that. Definitely taking a chance, because if that thing clips the pylon, it comes out to the 20. But instead, it goes out of bounds at the 1-yard line.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are locked in. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble. trouble.
And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Receiver complete, and they nearly get this all the way to midfield, marking down at the 49. That one covers 29 yards, first down. Territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48.
Getting in there for the tackle, Marcus Williams. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
This now a third and four.
To throw. Lewis. He's going to let this one go deep. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Here's Tommy Townsend on to punt.
And he'll get this away into the icy winner air. And this will be out of bounds at the run here. The 12-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range.
Meanwhile, Jackson's thrown into the hands of Andrews. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Now it's Jackson. Side is complete to Andrews, his tight end. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. On first and 10, it's Jackson.
That's for Bateman, and it's intercepted.
And to the 40-yard line, and that's where the return stops.
An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call for second and long. What do? Run and try and get some yardage and make it third and manageable? Or challenge the coverage again, hoping for a bigger gain?
Second and 10.
To throw again, Lewis.
Oh, he's going up top for Wilson.
And it's knocked away and incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Here's Tommy Townsend now as he'll punt it away for the second time. An audible here to get a new look. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies. And that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football, they're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. They're looking deep here for Flowers. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. A one touchdown ball game, 14-7 our scores. We get back at it on EA Sports. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Here's McGee.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
It's a gain of three, and it'll be second down. Here's Jackson. Throwing the outlet, incomplete. That's Thomas. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They'll see about converting this third and eight. Jackson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big play there on the catch and run. 34 yards.
Well, that was a pretty good time for his first catch of the ball game, and it turned into a huge play as well. He's certainly not been a central part of this passing game so far in this one, but he made his presence felt there. A big pickup on third down.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. Throwing is Jackson. And this is going to be caught along the sideline. Nicely done.
Likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
On third down, Jackson. Complete on the diving effort. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
This is McGee. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Now a pause, and there's an injured Raven in need of some assistance.
We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium.
Here's second and 10.
Jackson from the shotgun. Over the middle, complete. It's Flowers. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a fourth and one.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I have to think that the wheels are really spinning in their play caller's mind now. That little setback there on first down. They'll have three more shots if that's what it takes, because they've got to take field goals out of their thought process. They need a touchdown and a conversion to tie this game. What play calls does he have on that sheet?
Back at the two now, here's second and goal.
Dobbins.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. The second down play not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there.
But they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play. Stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him to know.
And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins. His second touchdown on the season. And the Ravens are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and we are tied at 14. So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective, because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
Lewis now throwing to start the drive. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stopped that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Now Lewis on first down. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 87 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Gets it to Hardman, a jet sweep. On this one, and they need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call.
And again, he's over for the touchdown. It's their quarterback scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Jets answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a mistake, a surprising mistake there in the kicking game, as he sends that one out of bounds.
Come on,
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Now a handoff up the middle. And nothing much materializing there in the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From the gun, it's Jackson. They'll get this to Flowers, left side. And he's brought down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They go play action now, Jackson. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. And the Jets are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Well, we saw plenty of that during his much-heralded college career. He parlayed that into becoming a first-round selection. And now here he is making interceptions in the National Football League.
This is a guy that has all the physical tools, but the thing that sets him apart is what he's got between his ears. And that's the sixth sense for knowing where the football is going. Just an excellent play there to create the turnover.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be tackled at the 45 following a gain of just two.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. And a run on the inside handoff. They'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1 yard pickup leads to fourth down. Here's the Jets punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
This offense in good shape. Two timeouts and the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10.
Rivers free. And he's got this down to the 35. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Now Jackson on first down.
Going for Bateman. He's got him on the out route.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. He's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
This is first and 10.
Jackson. Open man is Duvernay. Oh, no, he lost the football. And that was ball picked up by the offense.
But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself.
And I believe the referee's been buzzed. Yeah, they want to take another look at this call, and it's certainly a big one here late in a tight game. Now first and goal. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble.
A great move, but it only takes him to the 7. He's dropped there. The Ravens moving quickly here as the clock runs. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game.
Jackson to throw.
And it's caught.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
They'll try to run with Davids. And he is across and in for the score.
And now they can tie the game in the final stages with the extra point.
Or they can go for 2 and go for the win.
Come on, defense. Can't stop.
And now they're going to go for 2 and a possible win as this crowd rises to make things difficult.
Now Jackson.
And they do not get it. It's incomplete. They went for the win, and the big gamble does not pay off. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. The clock showing 19 seconds to go. And this is going to be recovered by the Hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
We got to have 2 hands on the football here as they run on first down.
And forget that 100-yard rushing game, at least for the moment, as he'll lose yardage here and fall back under the century mark for the game. So it's a victory here for the New York Jets. And we talked so much about the turnover battle determining who